Welcome to Times of Refreshing. I have Pastor Tina with me today, and we'll be discussing the topic, Hearing the Voice of God. It is an honor to come into your space, to come into your home, and we do hope that this program will be a great blessing to you. Thank you for joining. Thank you for being us. So Tina, you're welcome.
Thank you.
Jesus made a powerful statement in John chapter 10, verse 4 and 5. He said, when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. And a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. And in verse 27, he said, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. Hearing the voice of God is a very important topic, because everybody wants to know the will of God. And if you don't hear him, you can't know his will, you can miss it in life. Virtually everything in our life depends on our ability to hear God. So what are your thoughts on this this topic?
Well, just like you said, hearing God's voice is important, because that's the only way we can know whether we're pleasing him or not. We are made in God's image, and the ability to hear our Father's voice is what makes us able to do things in a way that are pleasing to him. And he said the sheep hear his voice, he knows them, and we follow him as sheep. So there has to be a relationship with our Heavenly Father that will make it necessary for us to hear his voice as his sheep. And the Bible also says that they will not follow the stranger, because they don't know a stranger's voice. When you look at family situations, for example, children in a home learn to know the voice of their parents. They know their father's voice, they know their mother's voice. And because of that, when they are in an environment that is strange to them, it's the voice of the parents they always look out for. So as God's children, it's important that we know how to hear his voice, and we know how to obey the voice of our Father when we hear it also.
So it is a process, isn't it? It's not something you master overnight. You know, sometimes people think, oh, when they hear someone says, God told me, say, this guy must be living next to God or something like that. And everybody has to learn. It's not, you don't become an expert in this overnight. In fact, you know, it's a progressive thing. I also noticed that, like you were saying, the children try to associate the voice with a person. The first time you call a child's name, a baby, and you say maybe Mary, the baby does not even understand that they are talking to, those words have been spoken to her. But after a while, the baby will listen, and then maybe one time will turn, and it's like, oh, is that for me? She hears that sound again, oh, is that for me? Then after a while, the baby starts to do things like nod the head or say yes. So I feel that as children of God, we must learn to hear his voice in the little things of life. Like someone said, if you want to know the way the wind is blowing, you don't look at the building that is moving or something is flying around, you look at the leaves. So I feel that one of the ways we can learn to hear his voice is to hear his voice in the simple, small functions of life. Which brings us to Romans 8, verse 15 and 16, where it says, "You have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God." So I don't know, here it's saying there will be a witness. We need to have a relationship with the Father. We need to know that He's our Father. Abba is like saying daddy. Abba actually in Aramaic is daddy. It's like saying daddy. And I believe that understanding must come, that we are truly His children. No matter what station we are in life, about that father-son relationship. The Father wants to speak to us. He's always trying to reach out to us. So I really feel that. So how do we, looking at it now, how does the believer cultivate that kind of relationship whereby the voice of God can become clear?
The example that comes to mind right now is the story of Samuel as a young boy in 1 Samuel.
Yes.
The first time he started hearing the voice of God, because he had a relationship with his father Eli, the prophet father as at that time, the first time he heard God's voice, he actually thought it was Eli that was calling him. You know, so it was a thing of relationship. He heard a voice. First time he stood up and he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me."
Yeah.
You know, and that first time Eli himself didn't quite know what was going on. So he just told the young boy, I didn't call you, go back. But by the next time that Samuel heard God's voice and came to Eli, Eli understood what was happening. And Eli said, "Look, next time you hear that voice, just say, 'Hey, your servant is listening, speak, Lord,' you know." And that was how, for Samuel, he learned how to hear God's voice. It wasn't like the first time he heard the voice, he knew it was God. You know, but gradually, it was a gradual process, just like you said. He heard that voice, and I'm sure after that, because he knew what God's voice sounded like, any other time God spoke with him, he knew it was God that was talking. And he was ready to do what God was requiring of him. So there has to be a relationship with God before you can understand His voice, before you can get to know that that voice. It's something you build. You don't just wake up overnight and, I know how to hear God's voice. But gradually, you learn how to hear His voice. You make mistakes. You correct the mistakes. But over a period of time, you get to know that, yes, this is how God speaks to me. You know, and you understand it. So a relationship is very important. Seeing God as daddy, seeing God not as God far distance, but a close relationship where you know Him. When the shepherd talks to his sheep, it's because there's a relationship between the shepherd and his sheep. That's why he calls them and they understand him. They will not listen to the voice of someone else that they don't know. So the relationship is, I think, the first thing when it comes to being able to understand the voice of God as the child of God.
While you were saying that, and I also thought, well, God knew that Samuel was a small boy, and God did not take permission from Eli to speak to Samuel. There are people that think, you know, it's about your age. It's about being a believer. Everybody, I mean, people say jokingly, you know, you're a father of somebody in the faith, and that person has a child, a spiritual son or daughter in the faith, that say you are a grandfather. But scripturally, God doesn't really have grandchildren. You're either a child of God or you're not a child of God. And I think one of the things that we learn from that story is that God had a relationship with Eli, but also wanted a relationship with Samuel, and he wasn't sending the message through Eli.
Mm-hmm.
There are people that believe that they can't really hear God except to go to a prophet, except to go to somebody, you know, who is big in God. But you can't really find that in the New Testament. In fact, that scripture we read, the Bible says, as many as are led by the Spirit, they are the sons of God. So every child of God can hear God. Every child of God can hear. When you know Him as Father, as Abba, Father, that He's your Father, He wants to talk with you, you can hear God for yourself. There are people today that they can't make a trip except they see their prophet. They can do nothing except they see their prophetess. They can get married except they see. And maybe later on we might get into that. But basically, the Bible says, the Spirit beareth witness. So how do you know you're born again? You know inside of you. Yes, the Word of God says you're born again. Because if you confess Jesus, you are saved. But you also know in your spirit, there's a witness in your heart that I am saved, I'm a child of God. I mean, many people will testify to the fact that their parents, maybe their mom, will just wink at them or look at them a certain way and they will get the message. We can get to a point in our relationship with God whereby, you know, the conscience is the voice of the spirit, of the human spirit. When you do something wrong and your conscience kind of strikes you and you quickly change, then you are beginning to train yourself. Because sometimes people think, okay, Samuel had the voice of God. So when we're thinking about hearing the voice of God, you might be thinking that it will be external. Now the voice of God can be audible, but it starts from the inside of a person, from the inside of a person. So, and I believe that if we start hearing Him, like we've mentioned, that we must be intimate with Him, so that we're familiar with that voice. If Frank could call you on the phone now, you don't need to say, who is speaking? You'll be used to hearing that voice. I wanted us to talk a bit about the place of the Word of God. Because the Word of God is actually God's letter to us.
Mm.
How does that help us to be familiar with the voice of God?
Well, the Word of God is God talking to us. And the more you read,